From Vancouver, Let's Go. Today, Let's Go presents another band special. And here are today's recording stars, The Shockers.
Just need someone to love. with tangerine trees and marmalade skies. Somebody calls you, you answer quite slowly. A girl with kaleidoscope
Vic Dana. I want some red roses for a blue lady. Venus, if you will.
Hi, I'm Frankie Avalon.
I'm Bill Good, Jr., and welcome to What's My Line.
Are you sure about that?
Not anymore.
I don't believe it.
The real Vic Dana and the real Frankie Avalon in Vancouver for a brief stay here. Welcome, both of you, and I would like to find out a couple of things while the band takes a break. You're both young men in a field that most young men are not going into these days, in recording and in clubs and so on. You're going into what I think most people term the popular music field. Is there a reason why you're not doing the rock thing?
Well, mainly in my case, when I started out, I had long-range view in mind of being a nightclub entertainer or anything, and you know, in the area of show business that was lasting. And I think that the other field, or the rock field, is great, you know, for a certain amount of time. You can make an awful lot of money and get an awful lot of exposure, but then you do get to an age where, you know, it doesn't happen anymore, so you need something else.
Frankie, is this a tough route?
I'll agree with that.
I
think that's important. I really do. You gotta think, plan for the future, and work along those lines. Otherwise, you know, you're here today, gone tomorrow, as they say.
Is it tough, though? I've always heard that it's very difficult to break in, that there's sort of a clique of people, Sinatra and Bennett and so on, and that for a young fellow, this is a very difficult thing to do.
Well, I don't know. Of course, they're very big stars, as we all know, but I think that there's room for a lot of people, and of course, in years to come, there'll be... The younger generation now will be ready for their own idols, so to speak, or people that they want to hear on recordings or pictures or television.
You find you have to be particularly versatile to do club work?
I think you just have to have a lot of nerve, you know, because audiences today are very spoiled. You know, they've seen just about everything and everyone there is to see, and they watch a special on television, for example, where you have, 100-piece orchestra, and they've rehearsed it for a week, and everything comes off beautifully, and if it doesn't, they just cut the tape and do it again. And they go to a nightclub, and you got a 5-piece band or something, and, you know, they can't understand why it doesn't come off the same way it came off on the special, or why you don't sound just like your records when you had 45 people in the orchestra. Yeah, things like that. Those are the problems.
Well, you've done, I think, 17 albums in the last 6 years?
Right, 17 albums in English and 5 in other languages.
How do you find time to be recording and to be doing nightclubs and all of this? You must never get home.
Well, for the last eight months, I haven't had time to record. I'll be doing that as soon as I finish up at Marco Polo.
Big Dana and Frankie Avalon in Vancouver for a little while. We hope we see you again soon.
Oh, thank you.
Like the nights in the summer, the city.
did our RCA Victor recording of Somebody Help Me. Right now I'd like to do a song we recorded for an album called Live from the Grooveyard. It's called Don't Bring Me Down.
1, 2, 3, 4.
To close Let's Go's band special this week, here are the Shockers with Come On Up, and an invitation for you to come on up with some letters. Drop us a line and let us know what you think of our hosts, our guest singers, our band specials, or anything else you'd like to comment on. Just write to Let's Go, CBC Vancouver. We really dig hearing from you.